Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we will design our ground. So right now we are using this cube and that looks horrible. So in this video, we will design a proper ground for our game. So first, select your current ground and delete it. Now open your arts folder and here you have an image or bitmap or sprite sheet and the name is ground sprite. So select this image and again sprite mode to multiple because it contains multiple images, and pixel per unit is always 256, remember this thing, and everything else is fine. So apply the changes and open sprite editor. Now this is our ground. So go to slice and we will do the same thing that we did for our player. So slice and then grid by cell size, and this time also the cell size is 256 by 256 and click slice. So we have all the sprites from this sprite sheet and we basically have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 images. This is the starting, this is the ending, and this is the middle thing. The same way, this is vertical ending and this is the middle part of our ground. So apply this change and close the sprite editor. Now you have 9 images or 9 sprites for your ground. Now we will drag all the images to our scene. So drag . So we have all the sprites. Now select all the sprites and click on transform and make the position to 0 and 0 for all the sprites. This is very important and I will tell you why. So all the sprites are at the center of our screen. Now what we will do, we will zoom in a little bit and then click here to get these axes. And now when you press control and move an image, it moves one block and it is very useful to create our ground. Okay, so when you press control and move an axis, it moves one block, remember this thing. Now this is our ground sprite 0 and it is the left start. So we will select this sprite and we will press control and we will move it to left side like this. Then this is our right end. So 0, 1, 2. So sprite 2 is our right end. So again, we will select ground sprite 2 and we will press control and we will move it to right side. So 1, 2. Okay. Now the same way, we will move this middle part to one step below. So it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we will select ground sprite 4, control, and we will move it here. Then we have this part, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we will select 7 and 1, 2. It is the ending. Now we will select this part, which is this one, 0, 1, 2, 3. So we will select 3, then again control, make it one step below, and then again control and make it on left side like this. You can see it is building the ground. Now the same way, we will select this thing, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is 6. So we will do it like this. So we have this part complete. Now we will select the 8th one and it is for this side. Then we will select 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So select the fifth one, one step below and on the right side. So we have all the parts. Now select the middle part and press Ctrl T to make the copy. So make sure you select 1, 4 and 7. Then press Ctrl D and move all to left. Then again select 1, 4 and 7. Press Ctrl D and move everything to right. Now you need to do it this way because we need the box collider. So we have a small platform here, and what we can do is we can select all the ground sprites and first create an empty object. So if you want to create an object to your scene, right click here and select create empty, and I will create a small ground. So we have small platform or ground, you can name it anything. So let's name it small ground. And then I will select all the sprites and I will drag it to small ground. So this is better. So we have one platform. Let's move it here. Now the same way we will create more platforms, but it is actually too small, so I will make it a little bit bigger. So what we will do is we will select this part and I will move it to 1, 2. That's enough. Now I will select this part, Ctrl D, 1, 2. Again select this part, Ctrl D, 1. And the same way I will do for this part. So move it here, 1, 2. And then select this part, Ctrl D, move. Again Ctrl D and move. So this is our small ground. Now we will select the small ground and again we will press Ctrl D and I will make medium ground. Let's move it here like this. Let's move the small one here, and this is our medium ground. So let's move it a little bit here. Now again we will do the same thing to make it bigger. We will select this part and we will move it left 3, and the same way for this part, 1, 2, 3. Then we will select it, Ctrl D, 1, Ctrl D, 1, Ctrl D, 1. Then the same way, Ctrl D, 1, Ctrl D, 1, and Ctrl D, 1. So we have our medium ground. Now the same way we will create one more large ground. So again we will select medium ground and Ctrl D and rename it to large ground. That's it. Now move it a little bit here. And again we will select this part and we are doing the same thing. So I moved 3 steps, and the same way here, 1, 2, 3. Now select this part, Ctrl D, 1, Ctrl D, 1, and Ctrl D, 1. Now select this part, Ctrl D, 1, Ctrl D, 1, Ctrl D, 1. So we have 3 different platforms: small, large, and medium. Now we are building an endless running game. So these platforms will be generated repeatedly. So we need to store all these platforms, and to do something like this in Unity, we create prefabs. So what we will do is inside our assets folder, we will create a new folder. So create folder and name it prefabs. And one thing I forget is I need to add a box collider to our platform, or else it will not behave as a platform because our player needs to stand on this platform. And to do this, we need to add a box collider. So select small ground and then add component. Again, search box collider 2D. And this is the box collider added. Now to the X, here is the size of the collider. And to the X, we will set, let's say, 8. Yeah. And to the Y, we will set 2. And this is fine. Now the collider is little bit bigger. So what you can do is click on this edit and make it little bit like this, and the same way for the left side. So we have the box collider. The same way, we will add the box collider to medium and large ground. So add component box collider, and let's guess, maybe it's 12. No, it's 13. No, 14. Yeah, it is 14. And Y is 2 because the height is same of all the platforms or grounds. Again, edit the collider like this and like this. The same way for the large ground. Add component box collider 2D. It is, I guess, 18. No, it's 20. Yeah. And 2. Again, edit like this and like this. Now save everything. And now we will drag all the grounds to our prefabs folder. So open this folder, select all the grounds and drag it to prefabs. So you need to do it one by one. So we have all the prefabs. Now what we can do is we can delete the grounds. And now I will drag one large ground like this and one medium ground like this. Now we need to generate the grounds because it is an endless running game, and we will do it in the next video. For this video, let's try running our game, and you can see our player is running on the ground. And I think we need to edit the box collider a little bit. So what we will do, I will undo everything. And here our collider is like this. So I will move it little bit up. So edit and move it little bit up like here. This is good. The same way for the medium and the large ground. And I think it is fine. Now again, do the same thing, drag it to prefabs. First, delete all the previous prefabs. So delete everything. And then small ground, medium ground, and large ground. Now delete all these grounds. And drag large one. And one medium one. Like this. Now run the game. Now it is looking very nice. So we have the player and we have our crown. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you liked it. And if you did, then please hit on that like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends. So thanks for watching. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.